Thank you, Madam Speaker. I can't think of a better time than now to invest in America's can-do spirit. And I would like to thank our chairman, Bart Gordon, for his years of devotion working to ensure America is prepared to compete globally. America has been at the forefront of every technological innovation of the last century, and most of our jobs since World War II have been created by new technology and innovation. I believe we can continue to lead the world in innovation and technology, and my constituency in St. Louis, Missouri can play a major role in that effort. Earlier this morning, I spoke with Missourians closely watching our progress on this landmark innovation jobs bill, America Competes, including Washington University in St. Louis and the University of Missouri. Because of America Competes, these two great universities will be able to work locally with teachers to spark interest in math and science for future generations, as well as to continue research looking into the next breakthrough technologies. Today, I also heard from Chuck Girding of Girding Enterprises, a small specialty manufacturer from Dittmer, Missouri, who's been assisted by the Missouri Enterprise Program that helps small and medium-sized manufacturers. America Competes would strengthen the Missouri Enterprise Program, helping manufacturers compete in the global economy and hire more workers. The section of this bill I'm particularly proud of will strengthen regional economies through the energy innovation hubs to help advance the U.S. transition to a clean energy economy and to support the growth of new sectors of the economy and jobs that come with them. In order for the U.S. to remain competitive, we need to invest in the technologies now that will create jobs immediately and make our economy stronger for the long term. The America Competes Act will strengthen how America competes and empower American innovation. I yield back.